Hi, I am Commissioner Winston Barnes of this great city of Miramar. Whenever we do bus tours of the city, one of the main feedbacks I get is how little residents are aware about the many facilities and services provided by Miramar, such as our environmentally friendly community garden in historic Miramar, or the extensive childcare and senior facilities offered from one end of the city to the other. The fairly new City Hall was prompted when staff reported that rodents were showing a particular interest in the old City Hall building. This led to the land purchase upon which City Hall now stands. Another story surrounds the police headquarters as well. A search was underway for land the city could purchase to construct the entity when someone broached the idea that land sitting at the very center of our city was probably ideal. Hence, the location of the police department headquarters across from the City Hall complex.
A most interesting narrative also covers the new police substation in historic Miramar. The request for same was ongoing for a number of years, and with planning and principled funding, the new substation should be ready for occupancy and operation anytime now.
One of the most gratifying comments I've heard from a resident on the last tour we did was when he said he would no longer complain about the taxes he pays. This after seeing the facilities and the services offered by the city. The wastewater treatment plant in historic Miramar is another feather in the cap of some of the most creative and energetic staff. As the city expanded, not only are there more residents at the service, but old facilities have had to be upgraded and others, like the East Plant, had to be created. There are two major entertainment centers: the Cultural Arts Center next door to City Hall and the amphitheater at the Regional Park. The coronavirus has changed how we provide arts, culture, and entertainment for residents. The city continues to upgrade the infrastructure, including the refurbishing of roadways, improvement in the appearance of the major thoroughfare Miramar Parkway, as well as the embankment of various waterways across the city. As a commissioner, I feel a tremendous pride in the way our city has risen to the challenge posed by the coronavirus pandemic. At a meeting with staff at the start of the pandemic, I proposed that our 2021 budget should focus on how much money we were not going to spend. Well, staff came back with a balanced budget while keeping millage rates flat and no reduced services to our residents. One of the most gratifying things in the 17 years I've served is to be involved in the distribution of food supplies for our residents during the pandemic. I devised a plan for residents who had challenges driving to the Regional Park. Working with Christway Baptist Church and supervised by my legislative assistant, Sherry Covington, we created a hub through which food supplies were distributed to residents of the general area. There's one couple, both stroke victims, who I chose to deliver directly to their home once a week personally. From the historic East Miramar to the very end, abutting the Everglades, the city of Miramar has continued to supply nearly all the needs of its residents, from daycare and senior centers, parks, to enhanced fire services, a modern police headquarters, and entertainment and art facilities. Yet to come is the Innovation Zone, new affordable housing solutions, and the creation of new arts and culture spaces. We hope you are more aware of the many services and facilities you can enjoy in this beautiful city we call home. Thank you, and stay safe.